Hey everyone, welcome to another video. This is Pascal Maynard recording for Channel Fireball. Today I am playing a deck in my quest to try to beat Eldrazi for GP Detroit, which is a modern and an infested format of Eldrazi's. So I've tried various decks so far and nothing is consistently beating Eldrazi. Obviously, it's just like way too good, and it's so hard to basically I think as a whole it's impossible to beat them, but if you are able to know which version of Eldrazi will be played in a said weekend, then you can play a deck that they're not going to have access to. You know, maybe one weekend they're not going to play blues, they're not going to have Stubborn Denial or Kills Recall or whatever. So I think depending on the weekend, it's possible to beat them, to have a deck that's actually like favored against them. But I think in general, like, they have so much tool, they can be basically any color, which means they can have any sideboard cards and they can possibly beat any linear strategy. And I think any strategy that's not linear is not good against Eldrazi because it's too powerful and too fast. And it also has a great late game. So yeah, it's just too good. What can I say? So in my quest to finding a deck that's good against, so the current version of the deck being played is blue and white, which has, against Ad Nauseam, it has Stubborn Denial and Stony Silence. So I haven't played enough yet to know if those cards are actually good enough for them to win the matchup. Because one thing they have, so one problem they have with the colored versions of Eldrazi, and the problem, it's not a problem that Colorless has, is all the colored sideboard cards you have, they're much worse. The reason is their deck is kind of forced to keep hands with the lands, the Eldrazi Temple or Iohugen. So if they have, like, let's say Stubborn Denial and Stony Silence, well, first of, they might not have a temple and Iohugen, so they might be forced to mulligan. And second of all, they might not even have a colored source because they play like Urborg, they play Cavern of Souls, they play some basics, so it might not be the right color. They have Caves of Coilus, which is only a white source. So basically, you get the point that they have a lot of colored colorless sources, or sources that just didn't cast their sideboard cards. So I think colored sideboard cards are a little bit less impactful in their deck than it would be in say like Abzan or whatever, because they would always be able to cast them, and they also wouldn't be forced to keep hands that have the Eldrazi lands. So anyways, I'm gonna get onto that Ad Nauseam deck now. So this is a fairly stock list. I think the only numbers that changes from list to list lately is the number of spoils level and the number of packs. So I took Daniel Grafensteiner's list, which was my only loss in Swiss rounds at the Pro Tour, and I thought his list was pretty good. I just made the few changes. He had three packs of negation, which I think is somewhat unuseful since no one plays counter spells in the format. This is obviously, sometimes it's more useful than you would think, because you can just pack the negation the turn before you were about to Angel's Grace Ad Nauseam. So then you packed, and then on your turn you play Angel's Grace in response to the trigger. You don't lose the game, you draw, you Ad Nauseam in combo. So that's kind of cool. But I actually like Slaughter Pact a lot against Affinity and Eldrazi. So I have two Slaughter Pacts here. Maybe it should be three, I'm not completely sure yet. The mana base is the same as he had. It's fairly stock, just like a four of everything. Two temples and two blue-white lands. You want four black temples because Ad Nauseam is double black, obviously. And the rest, the sideboard again is, I played a few matches so far, and I don't really know what to board in and board out. So where I'm at now, but hopefully I'll figure that out. And if you guys could comment on this video and tell me if you think I was wrong boarding out a card and I should have boarded another card, and you have a reasonable reason to comment, then I'll make sure to read it and I'll hopefully learn. So we have four ley lines, which I assume are against so burn, probably burn, then against all the discard decks, so stuff like Thoughtseize, so most of the black decks. They're not that much played right now, so maybe I should not even play them. But to be honest, like, this deck is, as I said, it's so hard to board out cards that I think you can have a sideboard that's super narrow, but instead has super powerful cards. So then you only board out, like, let's say you board out a few pieces of combo, but you're boarding in extremely impactful cards, then I think that's the right way to do it. But like boarding in low impact cards to make your deck just slightly better in the matchup, I don't think it's worth it to board out, let's say, pieces of combo for it. So ley line against the black decks, it's probably fine against like Storm too. And then we have Urkill's Recall, which is for Affinity, obviously. Thoughtseize, which is against other combo decks, control decks. Then Holy Day, which should be Darkness. Darkness is essentially the same thing, but it's black. It's from Time Shift, Time Spiral. I didn't buy them because they were like 4 ticks each or something, and the only reason Darkness is better is because you have 2 more black sources. Well, it's not even true. There's actually only 1 more because I have a Plains here. So yeah, it's only optimal because there's 1 more black source in the deck. So anyways, I have Holy Day for that reason. And Talaria West and Baseju. So basically the Talaria West is another Baseju without being another Baseju. It also gets Slaughter Pact, Pact Negation. So you're going to be board anything against slow decks which have counter spells mostly. And you can also get Lotus Bloom or a land, but I don't think that's really happening. So it's mostly to get a Pact Negation or Baseju against the counter spell decks. So that's pretty much it. I'll be playing a league, which I already started, and I was 1-0 against Suicide Zoo. So I'll see you there. Yeah.